My friends, music friends, flamenco friends, friends of the music over the whole world, let's go on. Because I have a different map. I made this map. And what does it mean? Well, it means that the music from Spain, because we are going, we are making the quest for the flamenco, the music from Spain was part of the Mediterranean culture. So let's see this map. One moment. For to point it better, to point it out. This obvious is Spain, Italy, Greek, Turkey. Now Turkey, north of Africa. This is all roughly, don't think. It's all roughly. It begins many years ago, before the Boer Cruyff was born. Maybe 2000 years before, we don't know. All this culture from Persia, all this influence coming, all this also invaders going to Spain, from Greek, from Ottoman, this is now Turkey. You can say, well, Morocco is now Morocco, they called it Mauritania. In these days. The thing is, roughly, so many cult, many people conquered, invade Spain. And this is darker, don't know how Italy, because this is also a thing, is the climate. The south of Spain is warm, and the people are different. I think the same is in Italy. I'm for sure, they're not in Greek or Turkey, say it to me. Africa was all warm, all very hot. Sicilia, Corsica. So, in some way, Spain, roughly, see it, the south, what they call now Andalusia, from great part, the people are also more emotional. I call it spicy. Going to the north is colder, I know it icy. It doesn't mean that the people are not passionate and making music, it is different. Because, let's see, many instruments, many people, for example the guitar is coming from Arabia, it is clear. And also the fiddle, maybe, I think it is coming from Arabia. Or we can say the Middle East. But the people always are thinking, oh, Spain is exciting, it's Spanish, very Spanish, always thinking flamenco or Spanish music. But many people don't know that the north of Spain, Galicia, is here, Galicia, Gaelic, is Celtic. And they are playing that, the bagpipe, for example. So you can say Spanish, always thinking the guitar, always thinking the south of Spain. But Spain is more than that. There's north of Spain, and one of the popular instruments in Galicia, Asturias, is the bagpipe, as in Scotland. And this is the influence of the Celtic influence. In Italy also the music is more emotional in the south of Italy. The people are also different, more darker, not so tall as the north. The same in Spain. The Andalusian people is not very tall, many years ago, it's not changing. And the north was always different, more Celtic influence, and also this part of Spain, the east part, this coast here was from Catalonia. Well, there was a lot of influence from Carthago, from the Greeks. So, in some way, Spain is a melting pot. They are talking about fusion flamenco, but the flamenco is already a fusion of many cultures. And I think that at the end, when the Arabs came in 712 until 1495, 92, I don't know, in Granada was the last what was defending this part. Yes, there's a lot of influence, also in music, still influence. And the Gypsies came in, I think, from this part. It's also for Egypt. The thing is, in the north of Spain, living, there are living also gypsies, and they never made flamenco. What they are doing in flamenco, they learn from the south, but it dimmed to the north, the Spanish influence, it dimmed. Yeah? But the gypsies living in Valladolid or Salamanca, in the north of Spain, Avila, they didn't make no flamenco. They learned it from the south. So the gypsies living in the south, they made the flamenco or collaborated. Because this flamenco, Gitano Andaluz, they say. Yeah? So there's not any proof that the gypsies invent, were the creators of the flamenco. It's collaboration. I think this thanks, the gypsies collaborate in the flamenco, and all the people thanks to the roots, the very old roots of Andalusia. That they want to say. Yeah? So I don't like theory. Yeah? I don't like it. But I have to explain something roughly. Yeah? So, if any idea, let's listen to gaita. La gaita is the bagpipe of Spain. And yes, there is from something there. Let's see. There's gaita there. From Zamora. That is also a province, eh? In Zamora. You can hear the gaita. It's coming up. Gaita, Galicia, it is the Celtic part of Spain. Doesn't sound typical Spanish, eh? From the Basque, Basconian, for example. Women singing. This part of Spain. País Vasco. Chiquitito, Thais Basco.
Petik uzaila ja gorriletan kaila kantuz ogi petik uzaila ja gorriletan maitia gandik etxerakoan
also Pais Basko the
Basque Amore joak mainera bila, haren bortaino leiotan, maitit...
Now something was written also from the people from the Basques. The stone people from Basque, strong elf. They don't know the origin of the people of País Vasco, the Basque. It's very difficult to know. And the language of the Basque has nothing to do with the Latin language of the Spanish people. So they say, for example, good day, agur, it's agur. It's a very different language. Let's go to the next clip. You can hear the music from the Basques, País Vasco, music from Galicia, from Asturias. That's other people, very different. So Spain in those old days was, what they say, Iberian island, peninsula. Iberian Peninsula. So it was not Spain. It was very, very different. So it was not still made one country. So it were all different. You can say Spain. This is the reason it's so diverse, all this folklore. There were many, many countries. Well, not countries. You say not kingdoms. In the beginning. And the language was, they don't know. Maybe it was a little like Basque language, there's another language, but also the language had many languages over the whole. Not so great as America, but it is a huge country, Spain. But extremely diverse. I think that not country in the world has so many customs, so many music as in Spain. Well, my friends, let's go to the next clip. Thanks for paying attention. Bye-bye.